World Bad with Kathy is back. Sorry for not keeping updating the program, although I don't have so many subscribers now. Well, over the past few months, I've been trying to find new possibilities to provide you with the best stories. So my friends and I plan to operate a brand new channel named Knowledge Bass. It will be launched sooner and hope you will like it. It has been 8 months since NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang pulled the world's largest graphics card out of the oven. Even though the price of bitcoins has dropped, we still can't buy a graphics card. The reason behind this is the shortage of chips, which means the yield of chips can't satisfy consumers' demand. Actually, the chip shortage is not only for the graphics card manufacturers. It's a global issue, from America to India and China. Samsung has postponed to update its Note series smartphones. iPhone are also facing such shortages. Ford has closed its factory in Kentucky and Mercedes and Audi factories have shut down. Global chip shortage is reflected in news coverage. In June this year, a robbery occurred in Hong Kong. A high-priced chip with about 5 million Hong Kong dollars transported by a logistics company was robbed. If global chip shortage continues, we may see the following news in the future. AMD will become a company with the largest market value in the world, and it will become a religion with the most followers, with believers shouting AMD yes 30 times a day. Bill Gates will announce Microsoft will change its name into Michael Hart and start to make graphics cards. A new cryptocurrency named Chipcoin will appear in the market. The price will rise to 1,000% on its first day of debut. The Federal Reserve will then announce graphics card will yoke to gold. It's called the Bretton Graphics Card System. The chips will become the new symbol of wealth. Two chains will wear chains decorated with chips, and this will be followed by many rappers. Kanye West will launch a new Yeezy with a price of $1,000, only because the shoes are decorated with two most advanced chips. So the question is, why are the chips? Why the world is in chip shortage? Let's put a conclusion first. Chip manufacturing has long been an industrial chain with clear division of work. So who broke the industry customs and caused the global chip shortage? It's Donald Trump. Well, this episode is about Trump, but it's not all about him. In 2020, coronavirus changed the lives of many. To work or study at home has become a life routine, but it also increased global demand for electronics products and had a huge impact on global auto market. It's not necessary to produce more cars if they can't be sold. Therefore, the automotive chip orders were massively canceled. And accordingly, the actual capacity was shifted to the manufacturer of electronic products or digital product chips. But this change was not entirely market-oriented. There's also human factor. Well, it's just like the process of writing calligraphy. The pen is the lithography machine, the paper is the wafer, and the ink is equal to chips. So what are we missing now? All of them. Some may ask, if the market is short of chips, why should we produce more? Well, it's not that simple. First, chip industry is a low inventory industry. Let's imagine if the Apple company releases a new A-series chip every year. If we produce too many chips at once, then within a year, when the new A-series chip comes out, it will definitely depreciate in value. Therefore, in chip industry, sales volume will always decide output. But Chinese Huawei broke this rule. After Trump announced the sanction against the company, Huawei spent $180 billion to step up the stockpiling of chips. Most importantly, the US ban is like a sword of Damocles. No one knows who's the next. So the panic began to spread in the global supply chain. The first domino fell. Huawei had stockpiled chips for the next 2 to 3 years at once. So chip producers almost drained their inventories to meet Huawei's orders. At the same time, other Chinese smartphone manufacturers such as Xiaomi, Vivo, Oppo, etc. They also began to stockpile chips for fear of becoming the next company to be sanctioned by the United States. Actually, to increase production is feasible. Although high-end chip manufacturing has been controlled in the hands of several giants, the production of auto chip doesn't need too advanced technology. Currently, the chip manufacturing technology used by Apple, Qualcomm is not required in producing auto chips. Theoretically, you buy an ordinary pen, prepare a few ordinary paper, then you could ease the pressure of the chip shortage for Mercedes-Benz and Audi. But Trump kicked China out of the chip manufacturing process. The world's largest manufacturing country can't first transform its production capacity to chip manufacturing, let alone other countries. Unfortunately, they didn't seize the opportunity either. In fact, to build a chip industry is not that easy. Weather issues, local water and electricity resources should all be considered. This year, rainfall in Taiwan was below normal. Last February, blizzard hit Texas. All these factors made things worse in the global chip industry. Samsung really wanted to spend $17 billion to expand its chip manufacturing business in Texas. Finally, it closed two factories in Austin because of bad weather, which directly decreased Samsung's overall capacity. Adam Smith put forward the theory of free market, free trade, and division of labor as early as the 17th century. For a long time, the chip industry is under the domination of free market. Well, the market is cooperation. This test agreement could ensure that we can buy a graphics card with a proper price and buy the newly released iPhone or Xiaomi without extra price. But this test agreement was broken because of a ban. The free market can also be intervened. Can you skip the answer? Intervention could compensate for the defect of market regulation such as blindness, spontaneity, and hysteresis to ensure fair competition and prevent monopoly. It shouldn't be based on any political purpose or unscientific personal decisions. And that's all for today's video. Thanks for watching. If you like it, just subscribe and leave your comment. Respect!